1-800-235-5500. That's 1-800-235-5500, toll free. Call 1-800-235-5500.
At Carinet, we take our commercials very seriously. That's how we became one of the largest baby furniture and toy stores in the tri-state area. We don't play games here, we sell them. And at Carinet's famous low, low discount prices.
Carinet is open 7 days a week where you get giant discounts for little people. And no talking orangutans.
We know what kids want.
We were kids once too, you know.
Carinet, 1111 Old Country Road, Westbury.
Understand is how Uncle Everett could be in two places at once. The messenger said he got the money from him.
The messenger also said he made a couple of stops before he reached Bonnie's apartment,
during which time he got wind of the fact that Bonnie was trying to get hold of his wife to have a showdown with her. So he tore over to stop Bonnie, and that was it.
Come to think of it, he did everything, didn't he? Clucking over me to hide what he was really doing, and then getting Mona all upset.
Well, I should have had enough trust not to hire a private detective.
Shouldn't I have trusted you about those letters, too? Of all the silly, stupid... Forgive me, Di?
Yeah. Paul, this is where we came in.
I'm sorry. Byron. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, just goes to prove that a little trust is a good thing.
I agree with you completely.
Fine. Well, maybe you'll trust me with some money for lunch.
Tonight at 8, celebrate St. Paddy's Day with John Wayne and Maureen O'Hara in the grand old Irish love story, The Quiet Man. A three-hour special presentation tonight at 8 here on Channel 11. A special presentation from Channel 11.
Ellie's Furniture presents a special furniture warehouse sale. Special because you can now buy direct from the Kelly warehouse and save. At Kelly's Furniture, you'll find fantastic savings on living rooms, bedrooms, dining rooms, and more. You'll save because Dan Kelly is selling $10 million in inventory. Let Kelly's show you its large selection of quality furniture at super savings. Hurry to Kelly's in the Bronx, just over the Triborough Bridge, and in Queens at the foot of the 59th Street Bridge. Now, Kelly's Furniture for the best selections, immediate delivery.
The length of the programming course is 6.5 months, and it is substantially shorter than the computer program at other institutes.
One thing that I found very nice about Control Data was the individualized instruction.
I learned COBOL, BASIC, Fortran.
Control Data Institute gave me what I wanted. Now I'm a computer programmer.
Call Control Data Institute about a career in computer programming. Classes starting soon. 1-800-TRAIN-ME.
No matter what kind of plans you have for your money, the government has some plans of its own. They're called taxes. Now, taxes may be inevitable, but the Wall Street Journal contends that they're also controllable. So, the Journal keeps a close watch on the tax scene. Legislation, court rulings, new strategies, developments that might be important come April 15th. Then, in articles and regular columns, the Journal helps you use these developments to greatest advantage. So if you'd like to manage your taxes as intelligently as you manage your career, subscribe to the Wall Street Journal. After all, it's your money. At least for the time being.
Call 800-445-4400 for this great journal subscription offer. 13 weeks for just $29.75 with a money-back guarantee. 13 weeks, $29.75. Phone 800-445-4400 now for the Wall Street Journal.
Webster, weekdays at 6 on Channel 11.
There's a prayer that's breathed around in dear old Aaron's land. It's murmured on the threshold stone with a smile and a clasp of hand, and oft perchance it's murmured low with a sigh and a falling tear. But the sweetest blessing man can bestow is a prayer. God bless all here, and a happy St. Patrick's Day to you, wherever you may be.
The St. Patrick's Day Parade, brought to you by Refreshing Irish Spring, the soap that brings more shower to your shower.
And good afternoon to you. 40 years. In that time, I have met many people and made many friends. And they have contributed to this telecast, but one man stands out above all others. Joseph Timothy Patrick Sullivan, formerly the President General of the American Irish Historical Society. Over the years, he has taken the time to share with me the history of this town and the Irish that have come here in the American Irish. And so today, Joseph Timothy Patrick Sullivan, I want you to know that this one is just for you. Now, the vanguard of this, the 1988 St. Patrick's Day Parade, starts to move up Fifth Avenue. And as far down as I can see, the marchers come. And you'll hear the bands today and the skirl of the bagpipes. And Irish hearts will sing, mindful, of course, tempered by what happened in Ireland yesterday. Today at Mass, His Eminence Cardinal O'Connor said we could cancel this parade, but that would not be the Irish way. He said, we are 40 million in this country, and if 40 million would make their way over to Knock and pray for peace with the grace of God, it could come to pass. Let's remember those words today. We are 40 million, and we could make an impact. Now the 69th. The skirl of the first bagpipe today, Morris Whalen. Can you hear it now? Yes, it's a great sound. It's a thrilling sound. President Theodore Roosevelt said, this, the Garryon that you hear played by the piper, one of the most inspiring, spine-tingling marches ever written. And the Irish Wolfhounds. The motto of the regiment personified, gentle when stroked, fierce when provoked. It's a glorious day for a parade. There's no question about that. All along Fifth Avenue, a warm sun beaming down as we await this parade and have it unfold before our eyes. It's St. Patrick's Day in New York. Yes, and I look at it this way. It's very simple. This is the Queen of Avenues. It's St. Patrick's Day, the one day a year when the Big Apple becomes the Big Shamrock. So let pride and joy reign on our parade. We came here with little, and we've made our way, and we have made much. And we're grateful for being part of this country. And no doubt, I say this with all my heart, we have enriched the fabric of our nation. Now, all listen. Band of the East from McGuire Air Force Base, proudly coming up Fifth Avenue. And there is a major who is soon to become a lieutenant general. How do I know this? Because that major is my son, Peter Michael McCarthy, and I'm proud of him. God bless you, Pete. What a day and what a way to start a parade. The Air Force Hill. There he is. When he was in the sixth grade, he said he wanted to go to the United States Air Force Academy. And his wish was fulfilled. years ago, was it? 1951, my notes tell me. And a young lawyer at the New York AC quietly saying, you know, Jack, my dad saluted the Fighting 69th when they returned after World War II. Patrick McDonough, an Irish poet, been published. And he said, he did. Could you send me a copy of the poem? And these were the words that he wrote. They fitted then, it's different now, but they were inspiring. Come, children, to the window, dear. There's music down the street. And the tune I hear is the Gary Owen, and it thrills from head to feet. The banners wave and the soldiers come, cheering, rends the sky. It's more than pride and grief I feel, and the 69th goes by. Look, nearer now, they're marching past Old Glory to the fore. The flag they gave their lives to save, the fairest evermore. And we'll keep the trust our fathers kept, and their watchword, do or die. Like those that pass with martial tread, the 69th goes by. E.J. McDonough. The joy of spending evenings with him. Down at the New York AC, when friends would gather, just a bunch of fellas having a time to sing some songs, was always to point to Eddie and say, Eddie, your rendition, and he would be introduced as follows. When Edward J. McDonough was admitted to the bar, the church lost a bishop and the opera lost a star. When Edward J. McDonough was admitted to the bar, and then he would sing, her picture turned face to the wall. It was just great, high comedy. All right, faces in the crowd. This is the Veterans Corps of the Fighting 69th. And here's something to remember. This is the 69th consecutive parade for Jim Minogue, who hasn't missed a single parade since his return from France in World War I. And he was Wild Bill Donovan's secretary. And here he is. Up Fifth Avenue he comes with the veterans. They say, I love your coat. I'll give you the story of the coat in a little while. And the story of the coat is the story of Peter Duffy, the only Irish furrier in New York who was afraid I'd catch cold. And now here, Bishop McDevitt High School from Wincote, Pennsylvania. They're known as the Marvelous Marchers, and they have been entertaining those along Fifth Avenue for many years now, and it's a delight to see them here this afternoon. Bishop McDevitt High School Band from Wincote, Pennsylvania. Let's lend our ear.
Open your bag.
Okay. Oh, that's just that. I wouldn't open that if I were you. That's Irish Spring. It brings more shower to your shower. You see, it has a fresh light fragrance and soothing skin conditioner. It refreshes you like never before.
Next.
Bring more shower to your shower with all-refreshing Irish Spring.
The best training. It's the training that helps you get the job. And it's yours at Superior Training Services. With experienced instructors and hands-on training you can count on every step of the way. And job placement assistance to help you get off to a great start. For the best career, a career in truck or heavy equipment operation, you need Superior Training. Call now and we'll send you this free career booklet that tells you even more. Call the industry leader, Superior Training Services, today.
Okay, bring it forward a little bit. Keep it coming.
It ain't gonna fit, Charlie.
Just trust me. Hold it there. Slower it a little bit.
Charlie, it ain't gonna fit. Now,
take it easy. Just be gentle with it. It'll be fine. Just lower it a
ain't
little
gonna
bit.
Fit.
More.
Okay.
Just lower it.
Sorry, Charlie.
Just take it easy.
Okay. I knew it wouldn't
wait,
fit.
Wait, get it up.
Come on. I knew it wouldn't fit. No way.
If it's out there, it's in here.
I knew it wouldn't fit.
The 9X Yellow Pages. Why would anyone need another?
The Queen of Avenues and the Big Apple. For today has become the Big Shamrock. And standing here with me, the man, to my mind, has contributed more to Irish things in New York City than anybody else. I'm proud to call him my friend. This stand that we have today, the best ever, he put up during the night. James Patrick Moriarty. And a happy St. Patrick's Day to you, Jim. And please introduce your friends.
Yes, this is Brian Murphy here, and Niall Crowley, the chairman of the board of the Allied Irish Bank.
Thank you.
Niall would like to make a little presentation to you, Jim.
Jack, congratulations on 40 years of comparing this parade. And this is a little souvenir from us for 40 years of achievement. First created that mold 40 years ago, Balique Pottery.
How
and
wonderful.
In your honor. Congratulations.
Oh, please take a look at
continued
that.
Success with your work.
40 years. You know, I was just saying the other day, back in 1949, if I had known that I'd be up here 40 years later, I just might have taken better care of myself. Jim, aren't you involved with Drumolin Castle?
Yes, and Ashford Castle, and also the Irish American Sports Foundation. You know, Jack, we got £1 million from the Irish government, yep. Charlie Hoy, on matching funds for us to do, and we expect to be starting very, very soon. It's going to be built out in Tala. It's going to be the largest building in Ireland for public assembly,
right.
6,500 according to American standards, approximately 8,000 according to Irish standards.
Right.
So it's our friend, you know, and many of our friends are very, very involved with it. Allied Irish Bank are going to be involved with us,
right.
And all. So it's great times, and you know, we're wondering when you're coming up to Ashford. Drumolin is going to be open after being completely refurnished by Walter Curley and many others.
Right.
So we're very, very happy with our investments, both in Ashford and Drumolin. That's Jack, and so we'll be seeing you tonight at the Friendly Sons.
Indeed.
And Niall has to catch a plane to go back to Ireland now.
Well, that's
on
why
business.
That's why we put him on early.
That's it.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thanks for dropping by.
Jack, you want us to hold this for you or what?
God love you. It's what a big moment in the parade.
Oh, yeah.
Just to see you.
It's been a...
They're your friends. You're marching with your buddies. And you're... Oh, look at her. Maureen. God, you look lovely today.
Thank you.
To be with him again, because this is where you wanted to be.
That's right. Wanted to be right along beside him.
How you doing?
And here I am.
Will you come back later and talk with
me? I'll come back.
Please do.
Stephen's going to the end, and I'm going with him.
Well, every step of the way.
That's right.
Because that's your style.
Yeah. Thank
and
you.
Again, for coming down and
being with me a little later?
We got a wonderful gift yesterday. Pan Am said that they will provide Stephen and his family with free tickets to Ireland if he'll come this summer.
Mate, speaking of Pan Am, Pan Am flew my family up from San Antonio.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, and they made mention of the fact that the flying boats
used to go into Foynes
before there was a Shannon Airport.
That's right, and next year is their 50th anniversary, and there's all kinds of marvelous celebrations in Foynes, plus a new museum, and we hope, plus Stephen, this summer.
Oh, how wonderful, and they speak...
Please, God. Patty said she's ready to go now, but the weather isn't warm enough. Well, I said, wait for the summer for me.
We all feel that way, to go back to Ireland, go down to Glengareth and sing a song.
That's right.
You'll be coming
back. But now, we're losing sight of the king here.
Yes, Stephen... You made the broadcast for us. God love you.
He made the parade.
You bet. Gotta go.
Yeah.
He can talk now. Great. Beautiful.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Thank you.
I'll see you tonight.
Yes.
Good luck, Jack.
Hey, Andy. Thank you. Of Duffy.
Now, let me give you this.
All right.
This is our best scarf, and it's green because of Ireland. And we also have this special apple because Jack is celebrating his 40th anniversary announcing this. And this will remind him permanently, but you'll put it on your desk. It's the Irish New York apple.
Isn't that great? You know what I've said, Mr. Mayor? That this is
you
the
know who these guys are?
Of course, the commissioner. He always
commissioner
drops
Ward,
by.
And David Dinkins.
David Dinkins.
Andy Stein.
Andy, how are you?
We all came out.
How's your dad?
Say hello.
How's your dad? And this is, I have said, this is the Big Apple.
Yeah.
But this is the one day in the year when the Big Apple becomes the Big Shamrock.
You're absolutely right. What we have to, you know, pause for a moment is in memoriam for the three Irish people who died in the cemetery yesterday, shot down by an Irish Protestant militiaman. And he also injured about 50 other people, killed three. And the question is whether the British Army was in complicity. Did they hang back knowing that this was going to happen? I don't know. But there should be an inquiry to ascertain whether they knew those assassins were lying in wait.
You are 100% right, Mr. Mayor.
Thank
it
you.
Does temper the fond recollection enjoyment of the day. But this morning at Mass, His Eminence said, we could cancel the parade, but that would not be the Irish way.
No, it would have been wrong to cancel the parade, but His Eminence also urged that there be a pilgrimage to Ireland.
Right.
And when I came by, along with these gentlemen, each of us pledged to go with them.
Good. Thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
And thank you for the gift.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Andy, it's so good meeting you.
Nice to see you again. Really
remember me to your dad, will you? Good man. As they used to say in vaudeville, it is only the beginning.
We'll be back.
They call him the Quiet Man. They call her a wild Irish rose.
You keep away from my sister Mary Kate.
I said good morning to her.
Put them together and sparks fly.
Don't touch me.
John Wayne and Maureen O'Hara team up for a real Irish treat.
Do you hear that, everybody?
Don't miss John Ford's award-winning St. Paddy's Day classic, The Quiet Man. Tonight at 8 on Channel 11.
The best training. It's the training that helps you get the job. And it's yours at Superior Training Services. With experienced instructors and hands-on training you can count on every step of the way. And job placement assistance to help you get off to a great start. For the best career, a career in truck or heavy equipment operation, you need Superior Training. Call now and we'll send you this free career booklet that tells you even more. Call the industry leader, Superior Training Services, today.
I wanted a high-tech career, and I wanted DeVry. They're serious about education, like me.
Vince Crivellone, graduate, DeVry Technical Institute.
Got my education, and I got a good job. It wasn't easy, but it was worth it.
DeVry works closely with high-tech industry, so each course fits what high-tech needs today and tomorrow.
My future? It's looking great.
For more information, call 1-800-247-7800 now. DeVry, we're serious about success.
A greeting now from a man who is now marching in his 69th St. Patrick's Day parade, Jim Minogue, 90 years young.
Yes, sir.
Still playing the stock market.
That's right.
Did you take a licking the last time around?
Well, not too much. I got out in time.
Good man. And you're out here in time because we're delighted to see you.
Good, it's a pleasure.
With all your comrades being part of this big parade, you look forward to it each year?
Yes, sir, I do.
Well, Jim, thank you for coming by. It's been a joy.
Thank you, Jack. He'll get the reward in heaven.
Thank you. Well, here they are. These are my friends. How goes it, fellas? You bet. What a day for a parade, as I have mentioned, and the mayor mentioned, tempered because of what happened in Ireland. But the enthusiasm of the marchers, it shared their concern. But this is St. Patrick's Day, and according to the Cardinal, we should parade as we have done in the past. I'll say hello. Hey, you know you have everything going for you. You have the wind at your back, and you couldn't ask for it any more than that. There's a brisk breeze blowing up Fifth Avenue, not down Fifth Avenue. It's reflected in the spirit of the marches and the rosy cheeks of men and women alike, and they're young and old. There are redheads, and there are blondes and every conceivable color, and a few gray hairs. I'm here to attest to that. And, looking down the avenue, this is the Emerald Society of the Transit Police. In very short order now, Fifth Avenue will be completely bathed in sunshine. And the weather, just absolutely perfect for marching. Temperature, around 45 degrees. Brisk wind, putting snap and spirit in your step. And this parade, looking down the avenue, as far as the eye can see, this band will come by, and they'll be marching almost into dusk. The Emerald Society Piping Band. Listen to them.
the skirl of the bagpipes. Yes. What a great picture. Colorful. Ha ha. The Emerald Society of the Transit Police. Tradition. Yeah, we came here. This is one parade that you can look down and say, hey, we're here. We've arrived. We're proud and prosperous. In another parade back in the late 40s, 1840s, when they came here. Like a tidal wave did the Irish, coming up out of the holds of ships, in rags, many of them, walking across the piers to the jeers of pierside idlers. And they were on their way. They came to this land of hope, and they started. First, an accountant here and a teacher there. They stayed together. They had their culture, their heritage, and their traditions. And that's what it was all about, and their faith. And they made it work. In spite of all the vicissitudes that beset them. We were, make no mistake about this, the first of the second class citizens. We were the ones that suffered the ignominy of no Irish need apply. And nothing was done about it, but they kept their hearts high and their spirit because they had God on their side. And they persevered. Yes, they persevered. No Irish need apply. The signs started to come down one by one. And in 1960, the last no Irish need apply sign came down. And that was the one that hung in the White House. And John Fitzgerald Kennedy became first Irish Catholic president of our country. And we had come full circle and scaled the heights. So it's St. Patrick's Day, and we're proud to be part of this great nation. And we have contributed to the fabric of this country in every conceivable field of endeavor. And it's our day to lift our hearts to sing the praises of Ireland and of our country. And isn't it great to be an American? Because Joseph Timothy Patrick Sullivan has said on more than one occasion that this is an American parade in honor of St. Patrick. Never lose sight of that, he said. And Joshin, I remember, and I try to remember all we discussed, the hours that you have spent giving me so freely of your time. Sit down and listen to your accounts, the stories, and the events of the Irish and the Irish Americans here in New York City. And for all your kindnesses, I am deeply grateful, proud, and privileged to call you my friend, Joseph Timothy Patrick Sullivan. As I said at the start, this one is just for you. The Auxiliary Police Department of the City of New York.
onward they come. And I have now in my hand something that I believe is invaluable to those of us who treasure our heritage. It is a complete history of the St. Patrick's Day Parade, written by John T. Rynch. Going back as far as I can open the book, the time we first arrived here. And what brought this to mind was that I thought I'd share with you just one incident that took place on this parade, and this one would be in 1914 when the Grand Marshal was Marshal Flood, and the coroner was one Timothy J. Healy of the Bronx. Because, you see, he was a very stout man. The horse spooked, and he leaned back just a little bit too far, and the horse started to just sink to the ground. And then the people rose to the occasion, righted the animal, and he started up the avenue. And, well, the coroner was not particularly amused, but the people were. He was a very, very stout man, and it has been said of the coroner that, well, the only time he ever refused a meal or a drink was when he misunderstood the question. But it's all in here in this book by John T. Rynch. Tell you what, if you'd like to procure one of these, I respectfully suggest to send me, and this is most important, a stamped, self-addressed envelope, and I'll be able to tell you where you might buy it. The St. Patrick's Day Parade in New York by John T. Rynch. No Irish or Irish-American home should be without it. There we are. The Modus Drum and Fife Corps from Modus, Connecticut, and we will be returning in very short order.
These old eyes have seen a lot. Not long ago, they were blurred by cataracts. Couldn't see to get around. I had to depend on others. I hated it. I called cataract eye surgeons. They removed my cataracts at no cost. No surgeon's fees, no hospital fees. Transportation was provided. And they had me home in time for dinner.
Call 1-800-223-1212. 1-800-223-1212.
Is it possible, or even highly probable, that if you are considering starting a new career, changing jobs, or becoming your own boss, you might have overlooked one of the world's oldest professions, locksmithing? Is it a growth field, one where there will be a continued need for trained and skilled people? The answer is simple, yes. And you can be licensed and working in 12 weeks.
For further information, call 212-354-8777.
Dial a mattress, the easy way to buy a new mattress without leaving home. Just pick up the phone and dial M-A-T-T-R-E-S. We'll deliver any size and style mattress right to your door. Simply pay the driver upon your approval. Why hunt from store to store looking for a sale? Dial a mattress delivers quality bedding at great savings. Don't spend another night on that old mattress. Dial M-A-T-T-R-E-S and leave off the last S. That's the S for savings.
I'll tell you that mayor of ours is 1 in 3 million, or however many million people make up this great city of ours. What a beautiful face. What an attractive young lady. And the little ones in front, the St. Gerard Magella Drum Corps. Think about it. These youngsters have been talking about this for however long. We are going to march in the great St. Patrick's Day Parade. And I'm here to tell you we're going to put on a show like you have never seen before. That's the way they are. And it's just glorious to just understand the time and effort that these young people put in to preparing for the big event. You just like to take them in your arms and say, oh, you darling, darling kids. Look at the faces. Look at the faces.
Will you look? Yep, there she is. A pom-pom girl. She might go along through high school and then on up into college and be on television, but never with as much color and love as she is experiencing today. And here is their band. Well, we're slightly out of sync here, some of the marches, but things have a way on St. Patrick's Day of falling out and falling back, and sooner or later we catch up and we get things back to normal again. And there is a Mediterranean Irish, and that's Andy Albanese, and he is from my hometown up in Westchester. And he is there with his son, and he's dying to get on television, and this is not his day. The City Council of the City of New York and Paul O'Dwyer, now moving, silver-haired, what a wonderful man. Paul, how are you? Good to see you. The City Council of the City of New York and friends and family, to be followed by the pipes and drums of the New York State Courts. What we try to do all during the afternoon so that we will not intrude on the marching part of this parade, as you can see, is to split the screen. And we will endeavor right now. I see the City Council is in possession of a proclamation of some sort. And if you'll just step over here, my friend, and identify yourself.
Pete Malone.
Oh, Pete, how are you?
All right.
You
know, so right here at the New York City Council.
You bet.
And we want to make a presentation. You know, very rarely do council members agree on anything, but we've unanimously agreed that you're one person that we want to have this city specially honor, and you're now in the annals of New York City forever. And we really appreciate
wonderful.
Everything you've done for this town.
Well, it's
God bless you.
This town has made me.
Yeah, well,
and guys
made
like
us
you,
too.
Guys like you make it bearable. And I want to thank you. Don't read the proclamation,
no,
because you'll be in Albany by the time you're finished. Thank you very much. Paul Dillon, come over here and pick up the proclamation.
Right.
Andy, if it was written in Italian, you could read it, so you're out. Thank you very much. I'm now in the history book of this great city of ours, and the pipes and drums down the avenue. See the warm sun slowly moving across. And as far as the eye can see, the marchers will come, and they'll come, and the bands will play, and the skirl of the bagpipes will be heard, and you'll be hearing one in very, very short order. The pipes and drums of the New York State Courts. New York State Police. Perfect cadence. On the avenue, on parade. It's a thrilling sight. A friend has come to call. Would you mind stepping over here next to me, sir, and identify yourself?
Tom Constantine, Superintendent of State Police.
Nice name, Considine. You know they're Clare people.
I know that, from Venice.
Indeed.
Yes.
How wonderful. We'll have to talk about that a little bit later.
Yep.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much for the opportunity to be here.
Well, I tell you, I was over filming in Ireland a number of years back, and I had to down to Ennis to have my hair trimmed, and I stopped into a little barber shop. And when he had finished cutting my hair, he had these tonics, you know, in front of the mirror, and a little fellow. And I said to him, "Sir, do you have anything for gray hair?" And he looked in the mirror and caught my eye, and he said, "Sir, the only thing that I have for gray hair is respect." And that came from Ennis, Mr. Considine. Thank you very much for coming by.
Thank you for the opportunity to be here. Really enjoyed it.
Well, enjoy the rest of the day, because I'm going to do the same thing as you.
Thank you.
Laugh and smile a bit, and also be mindful of that terrible tragedy. It's hard to... You get carried with the music of the day and the skirl of the bagpipes, and yet in the back of your mind, it never leaves you, this terrible condition that has existed for hundreds of years over in Ireland. And as the Cardinal said this morning, that we should make a pilgrimage to Knock and make our presence felt. Let's hope that the grace of God, it can't go on forever. You know, we're 40 million strong, and if we 40 million, just think of 10%, right, took that pilgrimage, the effect it would have on Ireland. And Ireland needs our help. We left Ireland, but our hearts are still there. And I speak for so many of us today, mindful of what has transpired over there, most recently, the day before yesterday. Mark time now. The Emerald Irish War Pipes and Drums of the New York City Transit Police. It's a great sound. It's a thrilling sound. Yes, sir. Thank you for parading by. You look just great. Pride in his bearing. Now, I got an Irish-American here, a great, dear, good friend, and his name is Paul Dillon, and he's down here to help me as best he can. Paul, what do you think about this parade on a day like today?
Oh, I love it, Jack. We had this weather, couldn't be nicer. You have a nice heat system up here, keeping you warm, and
right?
Peter Duffy's fur coat. I wish I could jump in there with you, boy. It looks pretty warm there.
Paul, I came
we're
on the...
We're shivering out here.
I came on the parade side, right? And Peter said, "I want to see you." And I said, "Well, what about?" He said, "Don't ask me questions. I have my coat on." And he said, "Come over here." And, you know, pushy. I'm going to take exception to it. He said, "I want you to try this thing on. I put a beautiful fit." I said, "Why, it's this." He said, "So you'll keep the cold off you. Now put the thing on and get out there." And I said, "You're going to reclaim it?" He said, "I'll make up my mind later."
But it's not like the old days when you stood out in the snow and rain.
No, it isn't. The equestrian aides to the Grand Marshal. They add so much. Ladies, how thoughtful of you to come by again and say hello on this St. Patrick's Day. Men and women, remember these ladies and gentlemen, the equestrian aides, take care of these animals, and at their own expense, ship them to Fifth Avenue. Whoop! Easy does it. That's the way to go. Look at that little girl handle that horse. Look at that face, huh? Hey. All right. Ladies, gentlemen, we'll be back in just a moment.
There's magic in the air, and it's there for everyone who knows the secret words. Words that make whole places warm. Words that make a tough old city just a little more tender. Words that turn mere houses into homes. The secret words...
It's time for Little House.
Little House on the Prairie, weekdays at 5 on Channel 11.
Here you go. Continue celebrating the bicentennial by going back where you came from. To Scotland, Ireland, or merry old England. Or wherever you want to go. You call a shot,
Make mine Hawaii.
And you'll save lots of coin if you call Kalentours. Ha ha! At 836-6433. Kalentours will send ya.
America's winners are at your Chrysler Plymouth dealers now. Get our biggest cash back ever. $2,500 cash back on Chrysler New Yorker Turbo. $2,000 cash back on Chrysler LeBaron Coupe. Or $1,000 cash back on Chrysler Fifth Avenue. Let your Chrysler Plymouth dealer make you one of America's winners.
See your New York, New Jersey, or Fairfield County Chrysler Plymouth dealer now.
Fifth Avenue and Xavier High School on Parade. And you know, it was a mere 141 years ago that Archbishop Hughes decided that the Jesuits should establish a church and a day college in New York City. Father John Larkin was made its first president, and he came from a small village several miles beyond the northern boundary of the city, that is St. John's Fordham. And as Father Larkin tells the story, he started from Fordham with 50 cents in his pockets to purchase a church and a house in the city. 25 cents he paid for his fare and the cars. 20 cents more for the transfer of his trunk to a friend's residence. And that left him with 5 cents to found his new house and his new church. And so, in 1847, Xavier was born. Isn't that a great story? Think about that. What we have today, these fine young men, these cadets from St. Francis Xavier. You see the street now completely bathed in glorious sunshine. Sun smiling down on us. The drill team. The big rivalry in football between Xavier and Fordham Prep. When Peter, the major now in the United States Air Force, soon to become a lieutenant general, he played for Fordham Prep. 2 years straight, they beat him. I say that because it's pardonable pride. I'd like to see your son. I want to have you meet one of the real great friends I've had in the time I've spent around this city, a great Irish American. I'll tell you that just come right over here and Neil Walsh. Neil Walsh has devoted countless hours. And why? Because he's proud of the fact he's an Irish American. He knows that this land has been good to his folks, right, Neil?
That's for sure, Jack, my man, that's for sure.
And today you said you'd come by with something that would be a surprise.
Well, it is a bit of a surprise, Jack. You know, we started a new organization called the Knights of St. Patrick. And 50 Irish-American men and women have formed in this group, of which I'm very proud and pleased to be the chairman. And we each give $50,000 a year.
$50,000? Wait, each one?
Total of $50,000 a year. And that money goes directly to the St. Patrick's Day Parade Committee. It's going to make it possible for the first time in the history of the parade for them to have an office, to have a secretary, to have a central meeting place, because as you know now, the way they put this together is unbelievable.
You better believe it. I know more than anybody else because I went down through 40 years of it now.
You certainly do. And at the meeting of the board of directors and all the members, there are only 50, but we unanimously decided that this is going to be a 51st, and he's going to be an honorary Knight of St. Patrick. And I've been asked to bring this medal here on you to commemorate not only what you've done for this parade, but what a great American you've been over these years.
You make it sound so easy. And look at that line.
There it is.
This is your pride and joy.
That's my pride and joy, that line. And this year, I'm very happy, very proud to tell you and all your audience out there that that line today is the Jack McCarthy line for 50 years in radio. 40 years in this parade. And Jack, I can't tell you, I was almost crying this morning at the cathedral when His Eminence brought you up. He mentioned your dear wife, Mayor Soul, rest in peace. And they gave you that beautiful Waterford thing. Nobody deserved it more.
It was the most moving time in my entire existence.
I could see it was, Jack.
I miss her.
I know you do.
Great lady.
She sure was. I knew her well.
She is watching us today.
She's up there in that big end zone in the sky.
You better know.
And she's pulling with you today. Jack, good to see you.
Neil.
I'm on my way. I'm going to Disney World to see Susan Sullivan.
You are?
Yes, I am.
All right, but please come back and let's have lunch.
Okey-doke. Right. Good, Jack.
Great. Thank you very much. Neil Walsh. The Fire Department Holy Name Society. You know, I think...
Hiya, fellas. Oh, gosh, it's good to see you. What a day for a parade. I mean it.
Oh, my. How do you respond to something like that? How do you respond to something like that? All I can do is say I'm grateful. And I am your friend, and you are my friend. Seaford High School. Seaford, New York. Pretty picture they make.
Bar suggested I join AARP, the American Association of Retired Persons. I was surprised. I'm not retired. Far from it. Then she told me 20 million people, both retired and working, belong to AARP. It's for anyone over 50. A $5 membership fee brings me free information on Social Security and pre-retirement planning, savings on travel and prescription drugs. I also get Modern Maturity, one of the most widely read magazines in America. Best of all, I'm part of one of the most vital voices in America, a voice government really listens to on important issues like pensions and Medicare. You can join AARP today by calling their toll-free number. They'll send you a complete information kit, including news about AARP's group health insurance. Once you've paid your $5, you'll receive a membership card. Use it to get discounts on hotel and car rentals. You'll also receive a monthly news bulletin. Don't wait. Call for your free information kit right now. You owe it to yourself to join the 20 million other AARP members who are getting the most out of life.
Come join the people of AARP.
There's always work for a good mechanic. The way to learn is working alongside a pro here at Apex Tech. Engines, transmissions, electrical, carburetors, fuel injection, brakes. As you learn how to use each tool, it goes into your toolbox. In 6 months, you get your certificate. We recommend you for a job. Your toolbox is full, yours to keep. It's that simple. Call us. Oh, and find out how much financial assistance towards your training you're entitled to from the government. Now, I can't call you. Get up and call us now. 645-3300.
Friends from Ireland have come to call, and I should like to have them identify themselves so that we might meet them and know their feelings on this St. Patrick's Day parade. Would you mind telling me your name?
Cass Honan.
Yes.
I'm Speaker, Senator Honan. I'm Speaker of the Irish Senate.
Wonderful.
And I'm here representing the Irish government. And I have always been proud to be Irish. And I must say, never more than today in New York.
How wonderful.
And I sincerely mean that. It's a marvellous honour. When the Taoiseach, our Prime Minister, asked me 3 weeks ago to represent him and the government, I said that, you know, how proud I would be. But really, All it has passed. I wasn't, no way was I prepared for this marvelous display today and the tremendous friendship and support of you.
Why, thank you very much.
I warmly thank you.
And are you, is this your first parade in New York?
My first parade. I was in New York 20 years ago, but this is my first parade.
Would I be remiss if I were to say for you it's slightly mind-boggling?
It is, yes, it is.
Good. And but the gentleman on your left, may I meet him? Would you introduce me?
This is my Consulate General in New York.
How are you, sir?
I'm delighted to be here. It's a very great pleasure. And I wish you and everybody here and everybody who's looking at this program the warmest and the most wonderful St. Patrick's Day.
Thank you very, very much, sir, for coming by. We appreciate your coming by to say hello to all our friends out there.
It's a very great pleasure. And
you, by doing so, you add to the complete picture. Thank you for coming by.
Thank you, indeed. Thank
and as
you.
We say, gave me the poncho.
Slanta.
God love you. Bye-bye. Here we are. Yep, here they are. My firemen. Hey. That's pretty heady stuff. How do you respond, huh? I spent, in all probability, years with their fathers. You look great, men.
Look at those faces.
The Big Apple has become the Big Shamrock. And now, well, with pride and joy in my heart, I would like to have you meet close up. This is my time, because this is my son, Major Peter Michael McCarthy, soon to become a lieutenant colonel. Tell me, sir, as you marched up Fifth Avenue, what were your feelings?
It was absolutely fantastic. I think this is, of the 40 that you've done, this has been by far the best. The feeling that you get marching up the avenue, all of the people, the reaction they have to the parade is just fantastic. And believe me, I speak not only for myself, but also for the Air Force Band of the East. We certainly appreciated the reception the people of New York gave us as representatives of the United States Air Force.
We're proud of you.
Well, thank you. We're proud to be here.
And I'm extra proud because you are my son.
Thanks.
One great guy. Major, don't you hate to see a grown man puddle up around the eyes? But you got me doing it. We're a family, and your pride and joy, your flesh and blood, and to look at him and say, yeah, this is a man that wants to serve his country, and he's doing it. Graduate of Fordham Prep, the United States Air Force Academy, and now Major, soon to become Lieutenant General. Go back to your rank and let me get to work here, will you?
You bet. Have a good one, Dad.
God bless you, kid. Wow. And, oh, the Green Berets. Just look at this. Julio Castabile. How many parades have we shared together? Gosh, I can't tell you, but they are considerable in number. My glasses. The Green Berets. Every single one of those berets knitted by Julia Brown. This wonderful friend of mine that also has contributed mightily to this parade, Frank Cull, who is slightly under the weather, and I was with him Saturday night when I was named Gale of the Year at the Downtown Athletic Club, and I was able to meet the right people, so I'll be there when they have the Heisman next year. Nothing like getting your foot in the door. For a moment, I thought I was going to be out in left field because I couldn't find my glasses. You know where they were? On the top of my head. Well, that's what it's like to be Irish when you're on St. Patrick's Day, at St. Patrick's Day Parade on Fifth Avenue. Here we go once again. Oh,
Julia Brown must have sore fingers from all these berets. Jack, 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 Jack. These are the men, the firemen of the city of New York, who 24 hours a day put their lives on the line to protect yours and mine. They're the bravest. They are the bravest. And they are your friends. And they're my friends. And we share our admiration for them. Oh, man, dear. By this time, you must know that my name is Jack. We'll be back in just a moment.
Why transfer your IRAs to Schwab? Ask a Schwab customer.
I help people find ways to keep more money for themselves. With a Schwab IRA, you pay no fees. A transfer to Schwab is a smart move.
I transferred my bank IRA to Schwab because I didn't want to get locked into just one type of investment. Now my IRA monies go into CDs, mutual funds, stocks, you name it. Market changes? I could switch to another investment with just one single phone call.
I used to have a number of IRAs, all in different places, and it was a hassle keeping track. So I moved them all to Schwab, and now I have one IRA, one statement, and a lot less to worry about.
For a free IRA booklet, call toll-free 800-631-1700. That's 800-631-1700. Call Schwab now.
DeVry is very well respected. Industry knows what kind of people DeVry graduates, and they know what DeVry students are capable of doing.
John Legg, Burroughs Corporation.
Before attending DeVry, I knew nothing about electronics. After graduating, I now work for one of the largest computer companies in the world, and I'm proud of it. I would definitely recommend going to DeVry. It's an investment that I made, and I get paid back every day.
Find out more. Call 1-800-247-7800. DeVry. We're serious about success.
Paul Dillon. And, well, how many parades? This is about the third or fourth parade that we've shared together. As you give me your moral support to keep me on top of things.
Have you noticed the weather has been good ever since we've been doing this again?
Yes, how it's gotten warm.
I know.
But Paul, I keep thinking about this morning when Peter Duffy came by. And I had an overcoat, and I figured he said, it's too cold out there. He said, come on, I want to see you. And he said, try this on. And I said, come on, Pete, you know, fur coat like that. He said, just believe me, try it on and stop talking. So I put on, it felt good. And he said, now we stepped outside. He said, let's see how you feel outside. And I stepped outside, and brisk and the wind blowing, felt like $1 million.
It conceals your slim figure, though, Jack.
Indeed, I know. But I'll tell you this. I said, I'm wearing this for the parade today, Pete. You can pick it up later. And he laughed. He said, we'll talk about that later. Great little guy.
Oh, he's wonderful.
He is.
He's done so much for charity, too.
Well, yes.
In donating all, coats in, yeah, for worthy all, causes.
In all five boroughs.
Yes, he has.
Peter, you know, they come around to Peter, and he lends a sympathetic ear. And he's out there morning, noon, and night. And I know, I've known Peter Duffy for 55 years. And this morning, after I had this coat, and I said, Peter, I'd like to ask you a question. He said, what? I said, we grew up in New York City side. I said, in the winter, did you sleep under a blanket or under your overcoat? And he said, not a coat like that, and the overcoat. Hold on. Now, here we are. This is the honor group. They were preceded by Guillaume. This is County Derry. The Westbrook Drum Corps. And I must tell you about the Drum Corps here, leading County Derry, the honor unit, is host to
a muster that draws fife and drum bands from as far away as Ireland and Switzerland. And of course, Derry, if you have read Irish history, dates from the foundation of the monastery there by St. Columba in 546. The monastery was a particular favorite of St. Columba. And for the sportsmen, salmon and trout fishing is available on the River Burdonette and the River Fawn. The Fawn is controlled by the, are you ready for this one? The Honorable Irish Society, Derry. And the, I'm sure you must know this. It's entirely possible because I didn't. The beautiful Irish melody known as the Derry Air was written in Linavati by Jane Ross in 1851. And she got it from an itinerant fiddler by the name of McCormick. And as a bit of history, William Massey, the one-time premier of New Zealand, was born in Limavady, in Limavady Castle Rock. There's a great place over there where they have a fine golf course. And good test there, absolutely. And the town of Mahara, the birthplace of Charles Thompson, who was secretary of the first United States Congress, wrote the Declaration of Independence, his contribution to the history of our land. Harrigan. Divil a man could hold. H A double R I G A N U C. Harrigan, that's me. Harrigan and Hart, their contributions to the musical comedy of our country. These are the honor groups as of last year for discipline and the way they deported themselves on Fifth Avenue. The next one in line will be County Meath. Meath, among its historic sites, you'll find Tara, the seat of the High Kings. Tara, by the way, my daughter, is named Tara Siobhan McCarthy. And that is some kind of lady. And the Hill of Slane, where St. Patrick lit the Paschal fire. And an illuminated manuscript of the four Gospels in Latin produced about the beginning of the 9th century is probably the most complete triumph of illuminated art which the world has ever seen. And during the Cromwellian invasion, the book was removed from Kells in Dublin, later presented to Trinity College. A facsimile of the Book of Kells is in the Church of Ireland in Kells. And history is there. And as I mentioned, during the Cromwellian invasion, the book was removed from Kells to Dublin. And to repeat, later presented to Trinity College. And then now, Meath giving way to West Meath. Westmeath, that banner, one side, the Bridge of Athlone, which is enshrined in the hearts of true Irish patriots, and the other side shows the Hill of Ushna, a real landmark in Ireland's history. And above the hill, the characteristic motif, Westmeath. And here is to Westmeath, where the tyrant scarce could breathe. It's a song. You speak of Westmeath, you think of Mullingar and the famous races. And a stout lady very often might be referred to as being beef to the heels, like a Mullingar heifer. I think it's, it's England's a little bit testy when you say something like that. Oh, wait, here we are. Duilio, I think somebody else has come to call.
Congressman Dave Gilman, it's a great day for the Irish, but a greater day for Jack McCarthy as you celebrate your 40th year and bringing this parade to millions of Americans. And we thank you, and God bless, and may there be many more. As a tribute, we put a little something in the congressional record this week. And Senator D'Amato wanted to join with me. He's putting something in the record today. But we're in session, you know, and I have to run back. And he couldn't be with you, but our hearts are with you, Jack. May you continue for many years to come.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you very much. I want to show you. I'm in the congressional record. That's better than being on a police blotter. Right.
And only with a tribute, if nothing short.
Thank you, Congressman.
Jack, many good years.
Righto.
Good
health. Thank you, sir. Hey, Paul, take this. Big Apple is now the Big Shamrock. The sun is shining. Ira's hearts are happy. And we'll be right back.
There's always work for a good mechanic. The way to learn is working alongside a pro. Here at Apex Tech, engines, transmissions, electrical, carburetors, fuel injection, brakes. As you learn how to use each tool, it goes into your toolbox. In 6 months, you get your certificate. We recommend you for a job. Your toolbox is full, yours to keep. It's that simple. Call us. Oh, and find out how much financial assistance towards your training you're entitled to from the government. Now, I can't call you. Get up and call us now. 645-3300.
If you suffer from any of these medical problems, a contoured chair with optional heat and massage may help. I'm Art Linkletter, and I'm concerned about these health problems. That's why I want to mail you this free contoured chair catalog. You see, contoured chairs are orthopedically designed to provide the kind of firm support you need to help reduce pressure on your legs, thighs, hips, and back. And to raise your legs above your heart, all you have to do is press this button. If you're concerned about your health, get free facts by mail about contour. Find out about the marvelous relaxation that comes from the proper positioning of your body. Let me mail you this free contour chair catalog, filled with details on the health benefits contour chairs provide. Call me to get this important free information by mail now.
Call 1-800-258-9800. That's 1-800-258-9800, toll free. Call 1-800-258-9800.
If our exuberance is tempered somewhat, please understand that we are very much aware of what transpired in Ireland yesterday. And I find myself ambivalent. You cannot weep all day, but you have to understand that this parade speaks volumes for a people. And as our cardinal has said, if 40,000 of us were to go to Ireland to knock and pray, the grace of God, peace would come to that sorrowful land. The Emerald Society Piping Band of the Department of Correction. It has been said of the Irish that they were the builders of the roads, the canals, the railroads, and the cities. And that is true. The railroads, the Union Pacific going ever west, eventually at Promontory Point, hooking up from the east. Well, I have to say hello again. Hiya, men. I salute you. And you like the coat? I like the coat. You know, it's entirely possible before long Peter Duffy will not get this coat returned when the day is over. Yeah.
And so we were the builders of the cities and the canals and so forth. And the building of the National Road was just one project, though one of the most important, on which Irishmen were employed in large numbers. And watching the progress of the National Road between Braddock's Grove and Uniontown, Pennsylvania, a newspaper man wrote that he was fascinated by the great contractor, Mordecai Cochran, and his immortal Irish brigade. They were 1,000 strong with their carts, and their wheelbarrows, picks and shovels, and blasting tools, grading the commons and climbing the mountainside and leaving behind them a road fit for an emperor to travel. America was building, and it needed strength and desire, and the Irish supplied it. And isn't it sad in a way that at a point in time in our history, there were advertisements in papers in Ireland advertising, come to America, come to the land of hope, we need you. And the Irish responded in ever-growing numbers. And the work somehow was done. And now, immigration and trouble coming here. You have to have a green card. And they wonder why. Why us? Something should be done to change it around so that these people, these Irish people, people want to come here and play a part in this country's growth, as they have done since the famine years and even before. That needs to be addressed, and I hope it won't be too long before they come here in ever-increasing numbers. Glory to the four. Hey, fellas. Maybe I could. Man just passed by. He said, you could run for mayor today and get elected. And you know, he might be right. Hi, men. Good to see you. I know, and I love you guys. I was that young once, and now, 80. Hello there. Are you leaving us? You're going to the armory? Enjoy the rest of the day. It's an exciting picture, isn't it? The Suffolk County Police Department Emerald Society Pipe Band. In speaking with Frank Byrne, told me a combination of piping bands and bands from schools, there are about 110, I'll be specific, 110 marching bands here today coming up the Queen of Avenues. Ideal. As Paul Dillon stated, since he's been moving along the parade route with me and covering the parade scene, we've had nothing but great weather. Really, this is well, I'm dressed for it, that's for sure.
The sun's coming on our side of the street, too.
Paul, do you think I ought to get in the coat when I...
Keep it, Jack, keep it. It's too good.
The Suffolk County Police Emerald Society, Lake Ronkonkoma. I wonder if you knew this. It was in 563 that St. Columba went to the island of Iona, from which he began to spread the Christian faith throughout Europe. But what is not generally known is that Iona was the burial place of 48 Scottish kings and 14 other kings, including Duncan. You know, Duncan, who was murdered by Macbeth in 1040. Well, it was there on the island of Iona that St. Columba founded his abbey, and he gave the Scots the secret of the water of life, the secret of distilling whiskey. And I'm here to tell you on this St. Patrick's Day that if you happen to imbibe too heavily in the water of life, you're going to go right down the drain before the day's out. Oh, my. Another little bit that I received many years ago from a girl, and I can hardly remember her name. Actually, I do. But did you know that the word quiz was coined in 1780 by an Irish theater manager in Dublin named Daly? Is he better friend that he could introduce a meaningless word into the English language in 24 hours? And he hired boys to chalk Q-U-I-Z, quiz, all over the walls and sidewalks of Dublin. Now, no one knew what the four-letter words meant, but the word was quickly adopted, and it's quiz, part of our... I'm just trying to find the word, and then I'll say, we'll be right back. We'll be right back.
Quiet man. They call her a wild Irish rose.
You keep away from my sister Mary Kate.
I said good morning to her.
Put them together and sparks fly.
Don't touch me.
John Wayne and Maureen O'Hara team up for a real Irish treat.
Do you hear that, everybody?
Don't miss John Ford's award-winning St. Patty's Day classic, The Quiet Man. Tonight at 8 on Channel 11.
A happy man I'm not. The Wiz has given away my pot of gold at her Saving of the Green sale.
Saving of the Green?
Aye. With their no-wait rebate, you get back $5 to $100 on every electronics item you buy. And this catalog you'll be seeing in your local Wiz store. We'll be showing you all the great Saving of the Green bargains.
'Tis a grand store the Wiz is.
Nobody beats the Wiz. Tell me something I don't know.
America's winners are at your Chrysler Plymouth dealers now. Get our biggest cash back ever. $2,500 cash back on Chrysler New Yorker Turbo. $2,000 cash back on Chrysler LeBaron Coupe. Or $500 cash back on Plymouth Reliant America. Let your Chrysler Plymouth dealer make you one of America's winners.
See your New York, New Jersey, or Fairfield County Chrysler Plymouth dealer now.
The Queen of Avenues. The Big Apple is now the Big Shamrock. And for me, a great, big, wonderful thrill to meet a man close up and in person, a man that I have admired for many, many years, Vincent Dowling of the Abbey Theater. May I say, this to me is a big moment.
Well, Jack, thank you. It's not nearly as big a moment as for me to be with you here, because I've known you so long, but not this close. I've admired you so much.
I was, it was 1937.
37.
Right, yeah. With Abbey players coming over with doing Juno and the Peacock.
Yes.
And Barry Fitzgerald Gerald was Captain Jike.
That's
and
right.
Juno,
Sarah
Allgood, yeah. And his brother was Joxer, a perfect Joxer, and Effie Shannon played that cameo role as Mrs. Tancred.
Mrs. Tancred,
yes.
That's your
and I still remember it,
that
Vincent. And then, not too very long ago, A couple of years back, she was still alive. I went to the Abbey.
Did you?
Yes. Well, I always go there when I'm in Ireland.
Well, you promised me that when you come over, that you'd come and see me.
Oh, you better know.
I promise. I'll greet you and sit with you, and we'll have a jar afterwards and meet the company. That's a promise.
Well, I promise you, I'll be on the phone.
That's great.
Because this is a big thrill for me, because the work that you have done for the Irish Theatre will forever be enshrined in my heart. It's just magnificent.
I'm so moved. I really am. It's not often that I'm speechless, but
you know,
it's a beautiful tribute for you.
For the want of saying something better, I'll say you're one hell of a man.
Thank
God bless you.
And you're one hell of a man. God love you.
Thank you. Back to the Avenue. What a wonderful, wonderful person to spend just a few minutes with a legend, a walking legend from the Abbey Theatre, Vincent Dowling. And believe you me, when I go to Ireland, he'll be hearing from me. That's for sure.
We'd like to get a picture of us together. This is one for me. Thank you.
God love you.
Take care.
...1,000 years ago, and the city of Dublin was founded. And as of this very moment, Carmen C. Heatherman, the Lord Mayor of Dublin, is in Washington, Grand Marshal of their parade, and now the Dublin Jackeens. And they have planned celebrations that touch on the arts, sciences, sports, that will go on throughout the year. Take my advice. Make a trip to Ireland. Participate in all this, where the experience goes beyond the dream. You'll be thrilled, and you'll have memories that you'll treasure the rest of your life. Hello there. All the young people here. My mother and my dad came from Dublin. There. Look at the people waving from the windows. Couldn't want it any better. Could not want it any better. Wearing a sash, Free Joe Doherty. Why not? when this parade has wended its course, the centerpiece for many of the American Irish will be the Friendly Sons of St. Patrick dinner at the Sheraton Hotel. In charge of the catering will be Ed Cade, General Manager Old Scally. Now, it's a great dinner. 2,100 men in tuxedos. Food the greatest. And for the Irish, it's something to look forward to. But there was another dinner that speaks of compassion and love on the part of two men for their fellow people. And that would be last Christmas time when Ed and Bill sat down, looked at what was happening in the hotel and discovered that the big room would be vacant. And they said, why not give a dinner for the underprivileged? And they went to the help and they decided that, yes, that's exactly what we should do. And a dinner was presented and they had a guest of honor, did this wonderful dinner for 1,100 people. And the guest of honor was Mayor Edward I. Koch. Compassion and love on the part of two American Irishmen for those that don't have everything in life. Says a lot about people, but these two people in particular, Ed Cade and Bill Scally. Great people, human beings. Love of their fellow man. Yep. Happy 39th. Sir, this is happy 40. I'm in the middle of it right now. We'll be right back.
American Heritage Magazine. It's been called the greatest magazine of history in the world. Right now, you can get 8 issues of American Heritage, the perfect gift for just $24. 1 year, 8 big issues for just $24. Call now and you'll also get this American Heritage full-size, hardbound, concise family dictionary, free with your paid subscription. Get 8 issues of American Heritage and the 800-page dictionary free.
Call 1-800-452-9100 now.
To me, investing is a lifelong proposition. Whether you're 25 or 55, whatever your individual goals, you must be diversified. You've simply got to build a prudent mix. Stocks, bonds, mutual funds, CDs, fixed income securities. Investing today means avoiding conflicts of interest. Get your advice independent of the broker performing your transactions. Today, more than ever, it's critical to reduce your investing costs. If you make your own decisions, you ought to be able to cut your commission costs in half, trade after trade, year after year. The savings over the long haul can maximize your total return. You define investing as I do. When you choose a broker, I hope you consider Schwab.
For a free booklet, what a discount broker can do for you, call toll-free 800-445-6000. That's 800-445-6000. Call Schwab now.
The shamrocks are growing on Broadway. The Palisades are all painted green. The town of New York is the county of Cork, and every girl is an Irish Colleen, and the Big Apple is now the Big Shamrock, and it's pride and joy that we feel for our parade in this, the year 1988. And while we are thinking of saying a happy birthday and happy St. Patrick's Day to each and every one, we want to wish a happy St. Patrick's Day greeting and best wishes for a speedy recovery to Teddy Gleason, the 1984 Grand Marshal. He's recuperating from surgery at Manhattan St. Vincent's Hospital. Well, Teddy, you'll be up and about, and we're looking forward to seeing you. But getting back now to the big dinner tonight at the Sheraton Center. Yeah. Two great speakers. First will be Associate Justice Antonin Scalia of the United States Supreme Court. The second speaker is widely heralded. A tremendous motivator, a very amusing after-dinner speaker, and he coaches the football team at Notre Dame, and that is Lou Holtz. So, prior to that, it will be a visit with Bill Shea, who was responsible for bringing National League Baseball back into New York when it didn't look as though it could be possible. Bill, one of the immortals from George Washington Prep, yes, where he excelled in football and baseball, boxing, basketball, and curling. He was their head sweeper, and excellent sweeper.
And Georgetown University.
Oh, and Georgetown University. Thank you for putting a period to that. So his wonderful cocktail party, and then the great big dinner. And I can only say, Paul, looking forward, that the day stretches out before us, and it's a gladsome time, tempered, of course, by what happened in Ireland.
Yes. The tragedy yesterday has saddened all of us. The Bill Shea's party will be a wonderful bash, as it always is.
Mm-hmm.
Lou Holtz has that football program turned around.
There's a man that's sitting over there with his family. That is the Major Peter Michael McCarthy. I can remember talking to Peter when I went out to visit him at the Air Force Academy, and he was doing about a 3.5 average. I said, hey, could you raise it? He said, I could raise it if I wanted to become a bookworm. Mm-hmm. He said, but I want to remember the joy and the comradeship that I learned here. I do have to tell you this, Dad. I learned to study at Fordham Prep. And that's where the foundation was, the 4 years that he spent under the guidance of the Jesuits. Hiya, fellas. Turn my head away just for
certainly
that.
Shows.
Right.
You have another guest, Jack.
Now,
hello, Jack.
This is Ray Hyde of Guinness Harp. And
hello,
happy St. Patrick's Day to you.
And a happy St. Patty's to you, Jack, and congratulations on this glorious 40th anniversary of yours.
Oh. We've had people coming up here all afternoon, and I don't know what to say. You know, after a while, you run out of words, and you want to be saying the proper thing at the proper time, but it's very easy to say thank you for coming by, Ray.
Oh, it's our pleasure, and on behalf of the book and on behalf of the Guinness Stout that spawned the book, we want to present you with this plaque commemorating this the 40th year you've done this. That's almost as old as I am, Jack.
Yeah, well, just a boy. Just a boy.
A mere lad.
You bet.
But congratulations, and may you have 40 more glorious years.
Thank you very much, Ray.
Thank you.
And
so
I just want to say, I mustn't forget the part that I love this name. Cornelius.
Connie Doolin. God love him.
Cornelius Finbar Joseph Doolin from Cork, one of their
from
great
County
athletes.
Cork indeed.
And a fine gentleman, and he moved this along.
He certainly
with
did,
style.
Starting late last year. This
right.
Guinness does not take these things lightly.
I know.
And this took several months to do, but we've certified it, and God love you.
Thank you very much, Ray.
Thank you, Jack.
Is Connie on the scene here?
Connie is out here somewhere.
Well, I hope he's watching.
I
Connie,
hope so.
Thank you for everything. Thank you, Ray. And we'll be back.
Thank you, Jack.
Right.
Next. Open your bag.
Okay. Oh, that's just it. I wouldn't open that if I were you. That's Irish Spring. It brings more shower to your shower. You see, it has a fresh light fragrance and soothing skin conditioner. It refreshes you like never before.
Next.
Bring more shower to your shower with all-refreshing Irish Spring.
Welding. At Apex Tech, you learn by working alongside a pro.
Oxy, Arc, MIG, TIG, plasma cutting. As you learn each one, the knowledge goes into your head, the skill goes into your hands, the tool goes into your box. When you finish your training, the tools are yours to keep. Call now to find out about financial assistance towards your training you may be entitled to from the government, and about job placement when you get your certificate. Now, I can't call you. You have to call us.
645-3300. My wild Irish rose, the sweetest flower that grows, and someday for my sake she may let me take the bloom from my wild Irish rose.
St. Paddy's Day, celebrate with the only American beer that's also brewed and bottled in Ireland, Budweiser.
Listen to this girl of the bagpipes and meet a friend of mine from Westchester, Andy O'Rourke.
How you doing, Jack?
I'll tell you, Andy.
Good to be here with you.
I'm delighted to have you here because... Where would you? Oh, yes. Thank you. I just want to make sure we get your
remarks. I'm on, Jack. I'm delighted to be here for your 40th anniversary of this parade. That's really great. Westchester's very proud of you, you know that.
Thank you very much, Andy. And to me, it has been a joy living there. I raised my family up there and all my friends in Eastchester. By the way, when Westchester went by, there's a little girl close by that I remember dancing, and now she's in a beauty contest. I had the paper here somewhere, but the parade is out of sync and covering the different units, but I wanted to devote my attention for the moment to you and what we have here.
Well, Jack, listen, we are very, very proud of you, the job you've done, the fact you've advanced the Irish over all these years, and certainly the broadcasting world. And so on behalf of Westchester County, I'm going to give you this Medal of Merit. And this is a very formal presentation. We're not going to quite do it with the drums and the bands, even though I brought some of those with me in the background. But on behalf of all the million people of Westchester County, Jack, this is the Westchester County Award of Merit for you, for the great job you've done for everybody, not only the Irish and not only the people in New York, but for all the people around the United States.
Thank you very, very much.
My pleasure,
Andy,
to be here with you.
You're some kind of man. And, you know, I said before when I had my son up here, I'm touched, deeply touched, and these things have been coming along all through the afternoon, and I'm deeply, deeply grateful.
And you deserve every one of them.
Thank you very much.
Take care.
God bless.
Have another 40 years.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Well, that lady down there, I don't know. Well, that lady down there, I see she spikes a responsive chord. How are you?
Pretty good.
Huh?
Very happy and very thrilled and very excited.
You went the whole route with Stephen?
Stephen went all the way to 86th Street.
Yes.
On the whole avenue, he was cheered by the police, by the public of New York, by everybody. And we're so proud of the Police Department of New York this year. It's just fantastic, and we're proud of Stephen. And when he got to 86th Street, he stayed to review all the bands and the different police divisions going through. And I think he'll sleep tonight.
I think he will. And we're speaking of Stephen McDonald, who was shot over there in Central Park 2 years ago and was paralyzed. And his friends, this being one very close to him, Maureen O'Hara, rallied around. And today we saw him come up Fifth Avenue, and he can talk. He couldn't talk when I saw him the last time.
Oh, he talks. He can talk your hind leg off now.
He would have competition with you. Tell me
something. Oh, now that...
Tell me, did you ever get to Donegal?
Yes, I did. I got to the southwest corner of the southwest corner of Donegal last year.
Great.
And I'm going. And this year, we hope Stephen's coming.
Mm-hmm.
I think I told you before that yesterday I was at Pan Am, and I was very thrilled. I didn't ask for it. Pan Am authorized me to offer to Stephen and his wife and his baby and whomever would have to go with him tickets to go to Ireland this summer. And he'd come and stay with me and
what
the family.
Beautiful.
Isn't that wonderful?
Well, I was there.
Of course.
By the way, you cook great, great, great breakfasts.
Well, thank you.
And
he eats it, too. You know...
My son, by the way, speaking of Pan Am, they stepped into the picture and flew Peter up from San Antonio.
Isn't that great?
Right.
Yeah.
And they did say, I want you to repeat this. Before there was a Shannon Airport, tell us about Pan Am.
Oh, there was Foynes, where the seaplanes flew from the States to Europe. And Foynes was the great seaport of Europe at that time and the great terminal. And of course, land planes have changed all of that. But next year will be the 50th anniversary of Pan Am's first seaplane flights into Foynes. And there's going to be marvelous celebrations.
And your husband,
Charlie Blair,
yes, is a legendary figure.
Yes, he was a great legend in those days. He was, as a matter of fact, he was the first man to fly the Atlantic nonstop with passengers and mail in a seaplane.
My gosh.
And, you know, in Foynes, they used to call Charlie Blair the God who walks. And he was indeed. And in my heart, too.
You better know. Thank you. You are some kind of lady, and you brighten every corner that you visit.
Oh, thank you very much.
And just give me a slight buss on the cheek. There
you are.
I don't
think that color lipstick suits you at all.
Not thank you for coming by.
Thank you, New York and New York City, for your great welcome to Stephen McDonald today. He is such a happy, happy policeman today, and the police department should be very, very proud of him and his courage and strength and what he means to so many people. Two little boys, Jack, I've got to tell you this, two little boys about 6 years of age came up and stopped the wheelchair, and they just wanted to touch his hand and tell him how proud they were of him, and that when they grew up they wanted to be like him.
Wow.
I know Stephen's is in his van going home right now.
Great.
So God love you, Stephen. I hope you're looking. And we love you. The police department loves you. New York loves you. And you're an inspiration to all of us. And you give us strength. We steal from you. And thank you, Stephen, for being the strong person you are and giving us all hope and love and belief in God. Thank you, Stephen. A happy St. Patrick's Day to you. And thanks to the police department for really supporting him and encouraging him. And thanks, everybody.
God love you, Maureen.
Thank you. Bye.
John Wayne would be envy of that one, I'll tell you.
No, Charlie Blair would be madder at you.
God love you.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye. She's a treasure. She is a treasure. How are you, fellas? Oh, Iona. There, I've been waiting for this. All you people that have been watching this parade for four solid years, I've been waiting for Iona and the president, John Driscoll, to come up Fifth Avenue, and each time there would be a commercial. Today we just caught them as I was talking with Maureen, but he is a very extra special person, is John Driscoll. I call him Jack. A number of years back, just a few, he had the Dalai Lama visit the Iona campus. And the Dalai Lama was garbed in maroon and gold, school colors. And it was a wonderful afternoon. And reading about Jack Driscoll, he had a 6-month sabbatical. And he spent time in Kerry, but then he went to the East and he met Mother Teresa. And Mother Teresa said, you do what you do and I can't do what you do, you can't do what I do, but the two of us can do something in praise of our God. I think that's a wonderful statement. We'll be back.
Get a free sample of new Extra Strength Domes and this Craftmatic Adjustable Bed Catalog free by mail. When backache pain flares up, take new Extra Strength Domes and rest in a Craftmatic Adjustable Bed. It's the perfect 1-2 punch to relieve low back pain. In an inexpensive Craftmatic Model 2 bed, you can adjust yourself to get relief from low back pain and other nagging aches and pains. And this bed's so affordable, it actually costs $200 less than these quality flatbeds. So, for effective temporary relief of occasional backache, take new Extra Strength Domes and sleep in a Craftmatic adjustable bed. Call toll-free so we can mail you your free sample of new Extra Strength Domes and this Craftmatic adjustable bed catalog. Call to get them free by mail right away. There's absolutely no obligation.
Call 1-800-235-5500. That's 1-800-235-5500, toll free. Call 1-800-235-5500.
Just a reminder that every week in TV Guide, you'll find something colorful. Pick up your copy of TV Guide today. It's the best thing on television, and it's on sale now.
You don't have to do that. When I was going to wear it proudly when I go to the dinner tonight, I said, Maureen O'Hara kissed me here. That's great. I mean, if
you... I was going to take off, and I forgot, and I'm sorry, with all the excitement about Stephen, I forgot that it's Jack's 40th anniversary of reviewing the St. Patrick's Day Parade today. And I would like to wish him 40 more, and may I be here at the last one of the next 40. Please, God. Congratulations.
But you didn't have to do that. I wanted to bring it down. I wanted to bring...
I'll put some more.
All right, fine.
He's branded again. happy 40 years.
Thank you very much.
Happy 40 more.
God love you.
God bless. Reno.
Cardinal Spellman High School. We have a little difficulty from time to time as we get a little bit out of sync. These things happen during an event of this kind. Well, you know, if it was 10 degrees warmer, we'd be thinking about playing golf tomorrow, you know, playing the green. Well, I have this great good friend. I refer to him as my Mediterranean Irish friend, Peter Buzzati. He told me that all the top PGA, lady PGA pros are coming to compete in the 12th annual Chrysler Plymouth Classic at the Navasink Country Club in Middletown, New Jersey. Purse really large, and the champion 1987, Ayako Okamoto. There will be Nancy Lopez, and there's that Irish girl from Boston, Pat Bradley, and all the strikers of the ball will be there. I say this because it's a great game, and the Irish have embraced it down through the years. There are over 200 golf courses in Ireland, and you could spend hours and hours, and it changes from one course to the next, and that's the way it should be. There's Portmarnock, Royal Dublin, there's Waterville, there's Ballybunion. I could go on and on, and you people down in Jersey, just remember that they'll be there, and they'd like to see you. The 1987 champion, Ayako Okamoto, and the benefit charity will be the Family of Children's Service, FCS. They will benefit from this tournament, as is usually the case, now that the golfers play their part in raising money for worthy charities wherever they appear. Great. Said that over the 40 years I have met many people and made many friends and wonderfully warm memories. The year that Hal Madden was named the Gale of the Year by the Grand Council of Emerald Societies, to spend that evening in the company of Hal and his wonderful family, 9 children, and his beautiful, beautiful wife, Mary, out there in Long Island, and to see this man get up and pour out this love for Ireland. I tell you, Mary, you have yourself there a jewel. He's a great, fine, wonderful human being, and I feel myself very fortunate for saying he's my friend. Hal Madden, a great Gael. Now, don't tell me, I know, now, before you open your mouth, right? Your name is Joe O'Neill, right?
That's right.
And you're from Bundoran, right?
That's right.
Right? And that's up there in Donegal, is that correct?
That's right? Correct.
And what more needs to be said? Don't be nervous.
I'm over here, and I came over to see the fine gentlemen, the Emerald Society Police Band.
Yes.
They march in a parade in Bundoran, where we commemorate the hunger strikers.
Yes.
And that, and I want to see, can I get some more bands come to Bundoran this year? Out of this parade, I hope they all will come to see to Bundoran and make our parade as big, or near as big as St. Patrick's Day parade here in New York.
Now, without cutting me, right?
Yes.
How many people march in the Bundoran parade? Now, lay it on me honestly.
Roughly about 4,000 or 5,000 people.
Well, all right, that's a good start. Yeah. That's a real good start. Yeah. You're Joe O'Neill. I have a very dear friend by the name of Terry O'Neill, but his people are from Ballinamuck in County Longford.
Yeah.
And he was the one that decked me out in this handsome coat. And I wouldn't be without it today because, as you can see, there's a brisk wind blowing. And Joe, I want to thank you for coming by, and I hope by this time next year the Bundoran Parade will have increased to 10,000 marchers.
Thank you very much, and thank you for having me on your program. You're well-known in Ireland yourself.
Like, do you mean that?
Yeah, I mean that, Jay. You're very well-known in Ireland, and very well-known for all you do here on St. Patrick's Day, and also the people that organize this parade are very well-known for helping to try and get our country free just the same way as this country is free.
Good man.
And I hope they all listen to the Cardinal this morning when he said that we want peace with justice in Ireland so that we can have a free country the same as America has, and that our immigrants over here will help us again to get our country free the same way as the Irish immigrants when they come over here and help to get this country free.
Thank you very much, Joe.
Thank you very much.
Wait a minute, there's my man, Peter Duffy. Now, you've heard me speak of him, and you must remember that we go back 55 years, and, well, are your ears burning?
Yes, Jack.
So you've been listening to what we've been saying about you through the afternoon?
Yes, Jack. Thank you very, very much.
Are you deeply grateful?
I'm very, very grateful.
Great indeed. I was just saying that 55 years have gone by since we first met. And I mentioned the fact when we had, when you said, wear this coat, and I asked you because of our background, do you recall? it can stand being repeated. I said to Peter, look at this coat. We came from humble circumstances, more or less, right? Honest people, they worked hard. I said, Peter, in the wintertime, right? Did you sleep under a blanket or under your overcoat?
Well, Jack, in them days, we didn't have enough money for an overcoat.
Well, all right, fine, I'll buy that too.
Right, Jack?
Sure. Pete, this here, you might not get it back.
Well, that's probably all right, Jack.
You don't mean that, but I'll tell you, you solved the puzzle today. I would have been a little bit uncomfortable had it not been for you. Don't go away, because we'll be back in just a moment.
Okay,
continue celebrating the bicentennial by going back where you came from. To Scotland, Ireland, or merry old England. Or wherever you want to go. You call the shot.
Make mine Hawaii.
And you'll save lots of coin if you call Callan Tours. Ha ha! At 836-6433. Callan Tours will send you.
You start out with an empty toolbox. You work alongside a professional mechanic. As you learn to use each tool, it goes in your toolbox. In 6 months, when you've earned your certificate, we recommend you for a job and the tools are yours. That's how we teach air conditioning and refrigeration mechanics at Apex Tech. We have thousands of graduates out earning good money in this very good trade. How about you? Find out how much financial assistance towards your training you may be entitled to from the government. Now, I can't call you. Get up and call us now. 645-3300.
delicious, lean, always U.S. choice Fryrich corned beef. You don't have to be Irish to enjoy Fryrich corned beef.
At A&P Food Emporium, Waldbaum's.
Here we are. The Queen of Avenues. The Queen of Avenues, Peter. The Big Apple.
Beautiful.
Is now the Big Shamrock.
Beautiful.
And it's pride and joy that reigns on our parade. Yeah. I think about you as we go back down through the years. And I don't want to embarrass you, but I think I speak for many, many people with worthy endeavors that have come to your place and asked for your assistance. And you weighed what was needed, and if it was possible, you were there. And I can say no more than that, that you're a very compassionate, caring, loving man. And it goes without saying, I will have to say for myself personally, I count myself very, very fortunate in being able to count you as my friend.
Thank you very much, Jack. God bless you.
We'll see you at the dinner tonight.
Thanks very much, Jack.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Happy St. Patrick's
Day. Right, Dave. Now, just take it easy. We have a long night ahead of us.
Okay, swell. Thanks, Jack.
Easy does it. Thank you, Peter. Great little man. His deeds are unsung by many people, but those who know him are very much aware of the great good that he has done for causes throughout this area. Peter Duffy, my boyhood friend for 55 years. Hello, ladies. You look just darling. That's a handsome-looking coat you're wearing. Really, did you get it to keep you warm or to keep you quiet? She laughs at. How are you, sir? Good to see you. It's a great atmosphere. I'd be hard-pressed to recall the time when the weather was any better than it is here today. These are the people from Northern Aid on Fifth Avenue. And now, oh, look who just came by. Well, now, wait a minute. I have to do this. Now, Frank Cull, you have to know that the lady always comes between the two gentlemen. There you are. And if you think, Cull, that I was going to kiss you, you're crazy.
Rose between two thorns.
That's for sure. Claire Grimes of the Irish Echo.
I'm so proud to be here today with that standing ovation at the cathedral and that presentation of Waterford by the Cardinal to you. I was moved to tears. Can you handle a little more Waterford? Can you?